Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cuts Reactions, and my name's Greg, and I'm going to play some Rolling Stones. And, you know, I've played a bunch of Stones, and I was looking through, and there's a lot of stuff I think I probably ought to replay because it's, you know, a couple of years ago, and so at this point, you know, I can get away with it. But this is off the Sticky Fingers album, and this was such a good album. I mean, every song on it is really good, and, you know, people play one or two hits, and that's it. But this is Can't You Hear Me Knocking? And, you know, the cover photograph of this is just terrifically cool. I'll talk about the album cover in a minute. But anyway, let's just go ahead and listen to the song, Rolling Stones. That was really, really good. You know, it's like you had the first part of the album or the first part of the song, and by the way, this is the first album that Mick Taylor is doing all the songs on it. So you know, that's cool in itself. And so the two guitars are just great, and you've got this, you know, great standard rock and roll song going along there, and you know, great stuff. My God, Charlie Watts, you know, it's just. He does simple stuff on that drum kit, you know, but it's a simple kit, and he would just do, just solid, on the money, beats all the time. I mean, in some ways, it's what drove all of the Rolling Stones songs, even though, you know, guitars and of course Mick and everything is really prominent, but there's always that driving force behind them, and he's missed definitely. But anyway, you know, then they go into the second portion of the song, which is all instrumental. And, you know, the Stones aren't normally really thought of as being an instrumental band. You know, Mick is the front man, and, you know, it's what people think about. But, oh, man, they could really go to it. And those conga drums on there were great. But there was just so much going on that instrumental piece. You know, besides the drums and the guitars doing really nice different things. I mean, there were some beautiful, beautiful chords in there, and really pure sound. And then you had the saxophone come in, and it was like jazz and just so tight. So many things going on at once. It was almost too much to discern it in some places, but. Yeah, that was fun. So, anyway, what I was going to say about that album cover is it was so outrageous. They had just finished a record deal with, I think, Decca or something like that, and now they're off doing other stuff on their label. And that the photograph is by Andy Warhol, and the concept is by him. But you know, I had one of the original copies, you know, where they had a zipper and you zip down the pants and there was underwear underneath it. And it was really funny, just a funny thing. And the record retailers hated it because it wrecked all the other records in the stacks. And, you know, but it was just very cool. So. You know, another one of those things that pushes the envelope a little bit. Of course, the Stones always did, you know. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. One of the sleeper cuts, you might say, on the album. Every one of them's good. So I will be back and hit like, subscribe, and all that. And we will see you all then. Bye-bye.